Hi, Jim Shaw here from Griff's Group. Going to talk a little bit today about MIL-STD810 method 508, which is fungus. There's a couple of ways to do fungus testing. The first and foremost, the one that's really outlined in the procedure. This test, by the way, only has one procedure in it, so it's kind of nice. It's a little bit different from some of the other MIL-STD810 testing. This has one procedure, and it's essentially subjecting the materials that you're putting together in an electronics package or any other kind of package to certain spores of different kinds of fungi. And there's a European strain and there's a US strain, and so there's a variety of different ways that you can do this. But what are you looking for? You're essentially looking for the breakdown of the material that you're packaging due to either the material being nutrient to the spores or the excretions from the spores being acidic. So there's two failure modes there. One, you're feeding the spores and changing the material properties. The other one is the spores are excreting material and changing material properties. This can be a problem for electronics. And so, you know, a long time ago, there used to be paper wrapped capacitors or cellulose used in types of circuit boards. And all of that's changed now. And most everything is compliant with fungus being non-fungus nutrient. One case where the industry really hasn't changed is PVC. That is one of the places where you have to do something special to get the units to pass for MIL-STD-810-508. And so normally what you can do is you can just take a board, and using conformal coating, you can pretty well isolate any kind of components from nutrient growth. It is a 28-day test, and so that does mean that you can impact the number of qual units that you need or your qual test schedule. So you have to keep that in mind when you're doing the planning. It is a test that's done under high temperature, high humidity. It's kind of intended to simulate jungle conditions, if you will. And so if it's not in your schedule or your budget to actually do testing for the actual fungus testing, there is a way to do this with analysis or qual by analysis. And so that really requires that you access a database that basically allows you to look up each and every part that's in your system and then just verify that it's non-nutrient supporting. One of the standard approaches to decontaminating the units after they've been exposed to the fungi is just a common soap and water, hot water solution, or actually the spec recommends Lysol as a possible method to decontaminate the units. So keep that in mind when you're looking at packaging electronics, those are some of the things that you need to look for. Thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.